isolated thunderstorms in the west, maybe a little rain around Brownsville and Miami. You might get it again tomorrow, I'm sorry to say. It's been some heavy rain today, and we have you in the darker green through midnight tonight. So it just keeps coming, and if it's back tomorrow, we have a lot of unhappy people down at South Beach. Again, with our front, isolated or scattered thunder showers. Same is true in the southwest. Pretty quiet forecast going into this weekend. Still a little cool and crisp at night, but not as cold as it has been. So haven't seen anything about frost advisories yet for tonight. It looks like it should be above the 30s. That's kind of nice. Nice little change there. The warmth is returning. We don't want to rush things too much. Temperatures during the afternoon will be mainly in the 70s and 80s. Forget the 60s. You'll only find those in Maine or maybe Pacific Northwest, where the leaves, I'm sure, are starting to change with this kind of cool weather we've seen. But here we go. 90s start returning. Dallas, you bet you're going to be hot by Sunday. Oklahoma City, probably up toward Kansas City. Southwest, we'll see some 100s, and the muggy weather that we've had here may persist for another day or so. In the southeast, 90s return by about Monday, so it does look like a comfortable weekend. First part of next week is when it starts feeling like summer again, and it is still officially summer, don't forget. Next batch of cool air comes in across the Great Lakes. We return to the 60s, Green Bay, Detroit, possibly over to Cleveland by, say, Wednesday. All right, here's a look at the rain. Scattered showers and thunderstorms, that looks like a real mess, but we do think it'll be scattered, so not everyone's going to get the rain, and if you get the rain, it probably won't last all day. So go ahead and make some outdoor plans. Just keep a tentative backup prepared for Sunday in the northeast. Minneapolis, more isolated thunderstorms for you down through Des Moines to St. Louis, and in the southwest, more of the same. Monsoon continues through here. Might get a little bit of rain also into Oregon, Northern California by the first part of next week. So one front moves out, here comes the next one, and that slides on over toward you in the Finger Lakes and the Poconos. So you should see some showers and thunderstorms by, say, Tuesday. Remember, the little bit of cool air comes in behind this, and you get 60s after the rain across the Great Lakes. It's to the coast by Wednesday. Today's weather, well, the significant thing is probably the cool, dry weather in the east. One of the nicest days of the year. And look at this, 102 in Phoenix feels like 104. That's not typically the case, but it's muggy in the southwest. We think it'll stay uncomfortably humid and warm in the southwest, while the southeast is probably going to be feeling more like California weather than what you'd have in LA or Burbank. We also, of course, have a bit of rain today, not much, but some showers across Michigan and also some rain down into South Florida, which has been especially heavy around the Miami area. Stay tuned for your local forecast and, of course, the latest on Erica coming up. Thanks for joining us today. Jill Brown and Declan Cannon with you with our coastal storm now starting to wind up and some interesting things coming out of it, including some snow.
That's right. We've had reports from Mount Davis, which is down near the Pennsylvania-Maryland border. I believe it was a ski area that reported an inch of wet snow. We've noticed the same location reported over an inch and a quarter equivalent. So whatever snow has been falling, certainly been very, very wet. Right. Just marginally cold enough in some of the high hills in Pennsylvania to have the wet snow. And along the coast, the problem is not only going to be rain, precipitation, but some strong winds and some pounding waves.
Northern High Plains, enjoy it while you can, because the region will undergo a major temperature swing over the next couple of days due to a storm system coming out of here to the coast by this afternoon. In the meantime, yeah, it is wet out here. From Seattle, even some heavier rain. When you see the dark green in here, Interstate 84 is going to be wet until you get over to Pendleton. Then looks okay until you get down to Boise, where we had a record high yesterday, 72 degrees. Well, today it's rainy, it'll be cooler, and we're going to see some dramatic drops in temperature through here. So our system weakening as it moves inland. Our front to the north is the one to watch over the next few days. That, as well as this, you see all these clouds out here over the Pacific. They're heading east, and as they do, they'll bring in rain and snow to the west coast. Over the weekend, we're going to start to see things change. So enjoy the sunshine, a little break after yesterday's rain here along the immediate west coast, but not for long. A trough and some cooler weather actually sliding into Southern California, but this is the cold weather. Cooler here, cold here, and boy, we're going to feel it. 34 right now in Cut Bank, 38 in Lander. That's pretty chilly stuff. Denver should be a nice day for you, and actually out here in the plains, it looks like it's going to be good. Look at all these record highs. Oh, correct myself here. I said 72. It was 73 yesterday in Boise. Now, a lot of these places will be cooler today, and actually the warm weather should be out through here. May not believe it, but 43 in Rapid City is probably going to go up to maybe 70 degrees by this afternoon. Will we have more record highs? Well, it's possible. It's going to be warm here, we think, with southerly winds out ahead of that front. But then a big change, of course, coming up. You can see the clouds associated with our front north of the border. When that comes south, temperatures will plummet and we'll probably be talking snow within a couple of days. So get ready for that. You can see kind of the low clouds through here. They should be breaking up for you. Minneapolis to Chicago, we think you're going to see some sun. All right, talking about this afternoon, let's take a look at our good afternoon forecast. And we start you off with the Friday afternoon map. Looks wet here in the northeast, as Declan had mentioned. Still some dry air protecting you, but we think we'll probably fill in some of the blanks there and get a bit more rain and definitely some gusty winds along the coastline. Southeast looking better, maybe not clear, but better than yesterday. And then here comes our cold air and the snow across Montana. It slowly heads south over the next few days, so we won't really see snow into the Rockies probably until later in the weekend. In the meantime, West Coast dry for your Saturday. Looks great. Chicago, no problems. Cleveland to Pittsburgh, actually this rain should be fairly light as our storm slowly moves out. Unfortunately, it's moving slowly enough that you're probably going to be stuck with gray skies and rainy weather here in the northeast both Saturday and Sunday. But the heavier stuff is likely to come today into the first part of tomorrow. And you noticed here, we do have 1 inch to 3 inches expected. We've had a few reports of flash floods and flash flood warnings in Pennsylvania, and we may get a few more as the day wears on. Quickly.
Big changes this time of year. Hey, and speaking of changes, wet roadways in the northeast. We'll keep you posted.
Stay tuned for TravelWise coming up after your local forecast.